Hi everybody, Mrs Pileggi here. I'm going to talk you through your do it task. So you should have a sheet which has lots of different shapes with different fractions on. And if you've watched the last video, you'll have an idea about what fractions are and how to shade them. I'm just going to show you some examples. So here's one I've drawn. It says you have to colour in 1/3, okay? Now thinking back to the previous video, we need to look at the top number. This is how many parts need to be shaded, okay? And this part, I wonder if you can remember the fancy name, the denominator, is how many parts make the whole, how many parts all together. So we know that there are 3. So this is telling me to shade in 1/3, okay? So you'll be really, really neat and lovely at colouring in. I'm going to do it like that. Okay, 1/3. This one's slightly different. It doesn't show the fraction, it's got it in words. So it says 2/4. And if you remember, quarters means it's into 4 parts of the whole. It's asking me to shade in 2. I'm going to shade that one. That one. Doesn't matter which 2 you shade in. If you want to be really clever on the sheet, you can show it as a fraction as well. So I'm going to write 2/4. Okay. This one down here, this is a bit trickier. This is different, this one. It's asking me to shade in 2/3. And again, if you want to really impress your teachers when you send us your work in by email, you can write the fraction next to it. So I'm going to impress Miss McDonough. And I'm going to write 2/3. And I need to colour in 2 parts. There we go. And there's 3 parts all together. This one says 1/2. Doesn't matter which one you colour in. 1/2. And I know that's written like this, because 1 part has been shaded in and there are 2 parts all together. Mrs Pileggi hasn't got a ruler or a pencil or anything that I need at home, but I've drawn a different kind of shape here, which is a bit squiggly. You can try and make yours much, much neater. You can get your parents to draw it, or you can do it yourself. And instead of just doing circles, I've drawn a different shape. So this time it's asking me to do 3/4. So I know that I've got 4 parts that make the whole, and I need to colour in 3 of those. So 1, doesn't matter which 3 you colour in, 2, 3. Okay, and then if you want to, you could write the fraction out. Here's another example of how it can look in a different way. This is asking me to colour in 1/2. I'm going to colour in 1/2 the shape. 1 part has been coloured in and there are 2 equal parts all together.